Hello and happy Friday. I am Meredith. I am here with our message for the 27th of September, 2024. Back with the Oz and Wonderland Tarot for our message today. The sun's in Libra, the moon's in Leo. Got our retrogrades going on per usual. Let's see what the cards have to say about the energy atmosphere of the day. And before I get to that, I want to take a moment to thank you and send out some love to all of you who are sending comments, leaving messages on the videos, and sending emails as well. Your messages are beautiful and appreciated. I read them all, and I don't often get a chance to reply to you. However, heart to heart, thank you all so much for your messages. Love hearing from you. Okay, let's jump into the cards here. Energy atmosphere of the day. Per usual, Oz and Wonderland doubling up at the very least on many of the cards. Our first is the Four of Cups. I really enjoy this card. And when I started reading tarot, I was very by the book. Literally by the book. I was not putting a whole lot of my intuition into the cards. And so, you know, it was a learning process, of course. Though, as you work with the cards and you get to know them very well and you know their core meanings, they also have a beautiful personality. And they've got some different messages than what's really just written down step by step in a book. And the Four of Cups is one of those cards for me in tarot because, to a reader, I hear when I watch someone else on YouTube, and there are several intuitives out there that I really enjoy their messages, yet every single one of them really sticks to the apathy aspect of this, of the Four of Cups. And I feel that this card is a super solid surprise and delight every time we see the card, because you've got typically three cups knocked over, spilled, and or broken, as if to say, oh, ho-hum, the party's over, now what? And I don't subscribe to that way of thinking on a personal level, so why am I going to do that with the Four of Cups when you have a beautiful cup usually coming in the background with a divine hand holding it? So there's surprise and delight on this card. So to start out with a four, which is super stable, strong foundation in the emotional realm, we have some surprise and delight coming that is emotionally fulfilling for us. And we wait for nothing. Waiting is a waste of your precious energy. We're all about being and doing and showing up for ourselves. And so in the joy of that flow of energy, there's a lot of room for surprise and delight. So if you're not making room for it, this is a card to remind you to do just that. Stay focused in your heart center, stay grounded through your heart energy, shine your beautiful glow within your soulful presence, and be delighted by whatever the universe is about to surprise you with. Let's see what this card is paired with. The Lovers, excellent. Unity and harmony. And when you see the Lovers card, there's a choice that needs to be made. And perhaps it's just that, just what I was describing moments ago, making space in your everyday awareness, no matter what's in front of you. I don't care how long your to-do list is, there is room for surprise and delight on that list. And I know a lot of folks, you know, you just get up and you go, 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 go all day long. And I'm all for going, but I'm all for going joyfully. So make the choice to joyfully be in harmony with surprise and delight. I feel that's the opening message to our reading today. And that's kind of exciting. Next card, Page of Pentacles. Excellent card because we're focusing on what's growing for us. And there are some nuances in what's growing for us. New energy, fresh beginnings. This is a message that all the pages bring, and in particular in the Suit of Pentacles, this is something that's tangible that we have put on our beautiful Four of Cups foundation, right? So we've put some energies in place that are supportive of our unique and individual now moment experiences, And there is surprise and delight, and there is a fresh perspective to be celebrated here. This card is paired with, excellent, the Three of Pentacles. What a great card to have here, because this is building something that stands the test of time. And I can't help but feel that this is all related to the energies of ascension. And what does that really mean? The energy of ascension for me, and very briefly here, because this could be a very long topic to have discussions on. The ascension of energy is enjoying a level of energetic spiritual frequency in our everyday now. And it challenges us to challenge ourselves for everything that we do by rote and by habit or out of behavior. So we've put ourselves under a microscope and we're taking a look at everything that we do and how it serves, if it still serves, why are we doing it? One of my favorite little stories is, and I don't know where this one came from, someone out there probably has heard it and knows as well, that the story goes that a young woman was cooking her first ham for an Easter celebration. And the big deal about cooking that ham was to make sure to put another pan in the oven with the ham and fill it full of water. And why did we do this? Why did this woman always have to do that? Well, it's because it's what her grandmother did, but why did her grandmother do it? So it took decades for this answer to come. Everybody just did it. So her grandmother did it, her mother did it, and now she was doing it, but why? Well, it turns out the reason was the grandmother did it because her stove was out of balance. It was tippy, and the pan of water in the oven balanced out the racks in the oven so that nothing was sitting in there crooked. It wasn't for any reason for the recipe. It wasn't like it was a super special secret thing that the grandmother did to keep the ham moist or anything. No, it was seriously just to balance out the racks in her oven. And that's what we're talking about here. What do you do by rote, by habit, that you don't even realize or question why you do it? Well, I did it because my mother did it. I did it because my grandmother did it. Yet why is the question? So I feel like we're in that kind of energy. So that's the energy of ascension explained in a very simple, simple way. The why behind all of the things that we do by rote. And is there a new way that suits your frequency and your energy and your grace and ease in any moment for whatever it is you're doing? Does the behavior or does the habit actually serve you? Check it out. So anyway, we're building something that stands the test of time. We're making new choices and decisions and keeping space for, holding space for the surprise and the delight to absolutely thrill us in the journey. So question everything, folks. What's next? Beautiful. Six of Pentacles, generosity, reciprocity, right in the middle of the reading. And I feel like this is a beautiful message from the universe, multiverse at large, saying, I'm here and I meet you where you are. So how generous and how reciprocal is your awareness of the energy and the ways that you are being met? Check that out for yourself. Someone recently commented on, someone close and dear to me commented on my personality and my way of being. And I was so stunned by what I heard because I just don't think about it. I show up, I am myself, and that's it. Though I was reminded by this individual how amazing my presence actually is in the way that they enjoy the way I show up. I don't think about it. And probably none of you do either. So, and I'm mentioning it because that's what I'm feeling here in this beautiful six. And I feel it is the universe reminding each and every one of us of just how amazing and wonderful and incredible we are. It's important to acknowledge that for ourselves and for all the things that we do. And all the ways that we are being. We are miraculous in our own right. So let's take some ownership of that and then see how you are met by the multiverse, the universe, whatever you want to call it, by the divine all. And make way for the magic that comes with that kind of recognition. You are a miracle. You are amazing. And let yourself have a smile over that. Let yourself feel the joy of that and then see how you make choices, how you make decisions, and how you invest in what stands the test of time for you. Excellent. There's the Death card. Hello, Scorpio. You gotta love this card. It's all about transformation. It's all about death, renewal, rebirth here. And wow, right? That's pretty powerful when you consider it, especially in light of everything that was just said in the previous cards. This is all about the way you transform. Can you fully embrace what it feels like for you to be seated in the energy of your own soulful presence and navigate your day in that energy by percentages and in the 90th percentile of opportunity? Consider that. Consider showing up 100% in your soulful presence and your soulful awareness, not dulling your shine, not backing down, showing up real, raw, authentically you. And imagine how you can be met with the surprise and delight that's coming on this beautiful Four of Cups. I challenge you to do it. I'm challenging myself to do it too. Don't shrink, don't be small, don't back down. Be authentically lovely, wonderful you and see what kind of transformations happen because of it. And be a witness to the way the multiverse, divine all, meets you there. And the magic you make in the process. Leave some comments about it. I would love to hear what happens. Yeah, look at that. The Ace of Swords. What a perfect card. Talk about authenticity and truth. There it is in this one beautiful card. There's strength and there's brilliant clarity in this card. There's knowing and taking action on your knowing. There's taking action in your metamorphosis transformation that we've been talking about for weeks and weeks. And we're finally in an energy atmosphere that I sense is really embracing this, and not just embracing it, but calling for it. That's why the cards are actually leaning into issuing a challenge to test the waters and try that energy out for yourself if you've been holding back in some way. All right, bottom of the deck. What's going on there? How is the universe helping us out behind the scenes? Wow. Fantastic. Another ace. Ace of Cups. Love, bliss, joy, happiness on overflow. Get ready for the overflow when taking action in the way these cards are encouraging us to. Next, we have the Six of Cups. There it is again. That soulmate energy that we talked about yesterday. Having a soulmate relationship between our soulful presence and our ego awareness. Imagine those two really as soulmates. Your ego is nothing to fight with. It really is there for a purpose. And when we allow it its true purpose, real magic does happen. The love, the bliss, the joy, happiness is overflowing for us. Next, we have Seven of Swords, the card of potential self-sabotage. I'm actually delighted to see this card here for us because it's exactly what we're talking about throughout this reading. So when we hold back, when we don't show up, when we are not our raw, authentic, brilliant selves, we're denying the atmosphere, the love, the bliss, joy, and happiness that we're talking about in the Ace, the brilliant clarity, the strength, and the truth and authenticity of this Ace of Swords. So the Seven of Swords becomes a great point of focus for us because you can starkly feel the difference between the two energies we're talking about within this reading. And when we shrink, or if we go small in some way, or if we don't speak up in some way, when we feel really guided to, it takes something away from us in that moment. So figure out what that is for you. And instead, Use the energy of the seven to bring heaven to earth within your own heart space and muster whatever it takes to be the you of you. Yeah, right? Look at that. Because you got the Ten of Cups on the other side of this. How fabulous. And then you have the Six of Wands. Victory, success. Amazing. So Ten of Cups, Ace of Cups to the power of 10. Look at all that love, bliss, joy, happiness, miracle, magic on overflow for us. And the success that we are able to create with that by having an awareness of where, when, why, and how we have backed down previously. And instead, we're choosing to forge ahead and we're being met beautifully and gorgeously by the divine all. There's nothing to lose there, folks. All right. Angel Answers, if you've got a question, query, confirmation, you'd like these cards to answer, let them do that for you. And look what's popping out again. There's something better. You know it. We all know it. We all feel it. And I say, go for it. Whatever the better is, go for it. Speak it, take action on it, because another one of our frequent flyer favorites here on the channel, big happy changes, because our happiness makes all the difference. It makes all the change. Whew, I have broken out in a sweat doing this reading. That's a good sign. Ask for help from others. Another great card. That could be asking for help from the universe at large. Some of your besties. Your guides and angels. Trust what's coming your way. Trust yourself. One more card. And there it is again. Take action. This card is pretty persistent. We can do that. We can take action. Final word, angels and ancestors, how's our soulful presence speaking to our waking awareness, waking consciousness? We have two cards. We have the drum. Dream and journey. Yeah, be in the journey of your dream. That's what I take from that. And then we have, perfect, the heart guardian. Love and let yourself be loved. Trust that. Love yourself first and foremost. Show up as the love that you are. And then celebrate the dream in your journey. Have a beautiful Friday and an amazing weekend, everyone. Thank you, as always, for joining me here. Peace, love, joy, happiness. Namaste.